I'm glad to introduce a special issue of the Journal of Human Development and Capabilities, which just came out, and which deals with questions of employment, globalization, and inequality. This issue is an outcome of a special seminar we organized when I joined ISS about 1.5 years ago. And the reason for the seminar was that we felt that there was a lack of understanding of how the globalization process was leading towards different forms of informal and non-traditional employment. And the seminar took place actually in the same week as the markets in the US collapsed. And in the journal we treat also the question, what is the relation between these trends in globalization which have led to greater inequality in and between countries and to more unsettled labor markets and the crisis itself. And we found that actually the parameters that led to globalization have also been the causes of the crisis itself. So it's very important to deal with the causes of globalization and the social outfall, because if you deal with those, you can also deal directly with the consequences of the crisis. And we argue that it is very important to take more policy attention to employment and inequality that has usually been lacking during the globalization process. And we feel it's very important to deal with that in the current crisis. Firstly, because, as I indicated earlier, globalization, the parameters of globalization have led to the current financial crisis, and we have therefore to deal much more with employment and inequality issues. And secondly also, we often see in crisis what we call a ratchet effect, that after the crisis is over, the economy is on its feet again, but people, poor households, still face the consequences of that crisis. So there's a social effect of a crisis which is often lagging behind in economic recovery. And it's very important that in the measures to deal with the crisis, we take more attention to employment and inequality issues. We deal in that special issue with these questions from various angles. We look at situations in Africa and Latin America. We also do a review over past development trends and how they relate to answers to the current crisis. And we have a forward-looking article on the trends where the world economy will be heading. And the whole volume, actually, if you want to catch it in one or two words, is that the current crisis has shown so unashamedly that neglect for employment and rising income inequality during the years of globalization leading to the crisis have ruined lives of many families, and that corrective actions are therefore needed.